Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to run a Hugging Face model in Google Colab. So let's get started. So first thing is you have to spot the Hugging Face model which you want to run. So in my case I'm going to run the illusion diffusion model. The input for this model is going to be an image and we'll be setting a few parameters and it will give us an diffusion output. So that's basically this model. So now let's go and set up our Google Colab. So first thing, just Google Colab, you'll be getting the first link and make sure that you are signing with your Google account. So in the Google Colab, you'll be taken to an interface like this. Just go to File and click on New Notebook in Drive. And to the top, make sure that you're renaming it to your preferred name. Yeah. So first thing is we need to clone that particular models repo. So for that, we'll be using the git clone command. And before that, you need to change the run type. So it's going to be runtime and change runtime type. So change it to GPU. That's like quite powerful in case we are running image generation models, right? So make sure that you're changing that. Click on save. So as I told you, the first command is going to be exclamatory mark git in small space clone space. And we need to paste our Hugging Face model link. So just go to your Hugging Face homepage and this is going to be the link, okay? So in case if you are inside files, you need to come back and it just need to contain the model name and the publisher name, something like this. Just copy this and now you can see my files folder is basically empty. This is just a sample data, which is like the default data that comes with Google Colab. Apart from that, it's basically empty. So now if I just go here and put the link and just run this, yeah, everything has been cloned. And if I go to the exact same files folder again, this time we are having the illusion diffusion folder. So this basically contains this files will be coming over here. Basically, we're just cloning it rather than manually downloading each and everything and uploading into our Google Colab. So this is just a shortcut way. And next thing is we need to go into this particular folder. Okay, we need to go inside this illusion diffusion folder. So for doing that, the command is going to be, just go and open a new code. It's going to be %cd space, you need to just run illusion diffusion. So which is going to be this name. So you have to just copy this name or in case whatever the name that you have for your folder. So just have it and run it. Yeah, this is done. So now we are inside that folder. Again, go here and run the command ls, which is used to just list the files in that directory. And this is basically listing these files that are there. So now we are good. And next thing is we will be installing all the necessary Python packages. So by default, the Python packages will be listed in requirements.txt. So these are the necessary packages that are needed to run illusion diffusion. So for running that, the command is going to be obviously pip install. It's going to be pip install hyphen r and it's going to be requirements.txt space hyphen q. Alright, this is going to be the command and just run it. So this will install all the necessary packages that are mentioned in requirements.txt. Yeah, this is done and we need to manually install one package, which is Gradio, because here you can see we are having an UI interface, right? For that we require Gradio, but in many cases Gradio won't be explicitly put in requirement.txt. So we need to manually install Gradio. So for that it's going to be pip space install Gradio and run it. And that's it. I guess Gradio has been successfully installed. Yeah, it is done. And again, go to the code. So now we are going to run the app.py file. So before that, we need to make a minor change there. So go to files, open this. We'll be having this app.py. Double click it and it will be getting opened here. In this, we need to just make a slightest of changes. Go to this app with history.launch. Just put a comma over here and type share equal to true. That's it. You just need to have this command so that it's shareable. You'll be getting a link and localhost link, all the stuff, and just save it. Okay, I think it's auto saved. So if you just close it and again reopen it and scroll to the end, yeah, it's auto saved. Share equal to true. Yeah, that's fine. And now we can just run the app.py file, because this is like a main Python file over here. So for running the app file, it's going to be Python space app.py and just run it. And we are getting an error, no module named spaces. So I think this app.py has the spaces package. And I think that spaces package is not in requirement.txt. Yeah, it has spaces. So you can just copy this new one and it's going to be pip install spaces. So in case if you're getting an error, you can just separately do a pip install, okay? That would literally solve you the error in case if you're getting this module not found error, all right? So this is also done. And now let me just rerun this command. Just rerun this command over here. Run it. So I am getting this error, value error, your machine must be logged into Hugging Face. So I think it's now default that you need to have a Hugging Face token, and only with that token you can run Hugging Face models. So just open a new code, and for this we'll be installing HuggingFace underscore hub library. So it's going to be same thing, pip space install space HuggingFace underscore hub, and just run this. And in the meantime, we can generate our Hugging Face token. Just go to your Hugging Face repository and make sure that you are signing in. So you have to sign in with your email. So once you are signed in, just click on your profile, go to your profile, and you'll be having your settings. And in settings, you need to go to access tokens and just click on create new token. And just go with the read one. If you want write one, that's totally up to you. So these are the differences. It can make calls on behalf of you. For read, you can just make calls on API interface. So for this, the read token is enough. In case if you want write, you can choose write. So that's up to you. So I'll just have it as illusion and just click on create token. And make sure that you are copying this token and just click on done. And do not share with this token to anyone. If you want to delete it, you can just delete this. That's totally up to you. And this is done. Now go to the code. And this time the command is going to be from Hugging Face hub. Yeah, this is going to be a thing. Import notebook login, and you need to have notebook login function being called over here. And just run this. And here it will ask you to paste the token inside this box. I'll just paste my token over here and click on login. And that's it, the token is valid and the permission is read and the login is successful. Again, open a code, and this time we can just run our Python app.py. So it says name error true. So yeah, I did make a mistake over there. So I'll just go to app.py and I'll just scroll to the end, and it's actually capital T. Yeah. Okay, just put capital T and just rerun it once again. Yeah. And that's it. We will be getting here two URLs. One is local URL and public URL. I don't think the local URL is working. It didn't work for me actually. I was getting an error for some reason. But the fact is the public URL is working. So this link is available for 72 hours, the Gradio link. Yeah. And we'll be getting an exact similar interface that we got for our Hugging Face. But in Hugging Face, you need to be in a queue in case if it's a most commonly used space. So I'm here, I'll just upload an image and I'll just give a prompt. I'll go with the snow forest, something like this. And I'll just go with 1.8 and just click on run. So that's it, I am getting the illusion output over here. That looks pretty dope, I swear. So this is basically how you run a Hugging Face model in Google Colab. And this doesn't support all the models present in Hugging Face. There could be some models which could be like so large and it could require a lot of computing power. So in that case, I would recommend you to run it locally, but some lightweight to midweight models can be run directly. So I hope you have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. done a lot of tutorials in programming as well as AI tools, OpenAI, Gemini AI APIs. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.